Hi y'all, I'm Donna. Welcome to my garden. It is spring, well, in a couple of days, and my most favorite crop to grow in the spring is broccoli. I love fresh broccoli from the garden. It does not compare to anything that you can ever buy at the store. When you pick it fresh and you take it inside and cook it, it is so wonderful. So those of you who've been following me for a while on YouTube, you know my first garden was in Florida, and I'm in North Carolina now. Well, Florida, I was able to grow broccoli all the time. I never had a problem with what's called cabbage moths. But since I've moved to North Carolina, the broccoli grows great, but I always have a problem with those nasty little green worms inside my broccoli. Now, I can usually control cabbage worms, especially like on my kale, but just by spraying with a product called BT. And BT basically just destroys the worm's digestive tract. So, you know, the cabbage worm comes from those little cabbage moths when they lay their egg on those particular crops like the brassicas, such as your broccoli, your kale, Brussels sprouts, and kohlrabi. When those eggs hatch, that's where those little green worms are coming from. BT usually works for that. You do have to stay on top of it. You have to spray regularly when the cabbage moth is present. And where I live, they're present all the time. They are always active. So I'm going to try something new this year, and that is what you see here behind me. And so I'm going to get my camera. I'm going to show you this a little closer up here in just a second, along with something else I'm doing in one of my other beds. And then I thought about some other things I've done over the years, and I want to show you some old video footage from some older gardens of what I did to control critters, birds, insects, and that kind of thing. So hopefully you'll find at least one of the tips helpful and you can use it in your own garden. Okay, so I'm going to get my camera and I'll go over here and give you a good close-up look of this little thing we hope will work this year. Okay, so here's the first barrier that I want to show you. This is just a little, I guess you call them a canopy, a bed canopy, and it's good for indoor and outdoor use. It's a mosquito netting, and I didn't go out and buy this. I just happened to have it. I bought it, I guess, about 4 years ago because I thought I might be able to use it in the garden one day for something, and so here you go. I'm going to use it to keep the cabbage moths off of my broccoli and kale this year. And so this bed right here that I'm planting right here is going to be all brassicas. I'm growing in only this bed, and I'm going to keep it covered up until harvest time. You know, there are things called row covers that a lot of people use that you just put it over your crop when it's growing, and that keeps the cabbage moths off of it. But I really wanted something that had a lot of, would allow it for air circulation, to, you know, just to kind of prevent any kind of diseases like powdery mildew and that kind of thing. So that's what I'm going to use. And I basically just reused a lot of things they already had. At each corner, I'm putting a little shepherd's hook. So I already had those. Of course, you could use like a wooden stake or something. I had this tall shepherd's hook up here that I could hang it from because it comes with a little hanger there, and then the hoop kind of keeps it where it'll spread out. The thing I like about this also is that in the back there's an opening. So I'm just securing it to the pole here with a little clip that I got from Harbor Freight. And so I can just easily reach in here or also pull up on the side to tend to the garden. So it won't be like having a little tunnel underneath there. Now the other thing, I'm not quite complete with this, but I will show you some video footage where I used it last year. And this bed right here, I've already had a dog or a cat come through here and messed up some of my seedlings. And that usually happens early in the spring. We have rabbits and possums and stray dogs running around and the cats and that kind of thing. So I like to use bird netting. And you may have seen this at Lowe's or Home Depot, somewhere like that. And this is usually used to put over like blueberry bushes, that kind of thing, when to keep the birds off of them. When your blueberries are ripening up, you should toss this over your bush to keep the birds from eating your berries. Okay? So what I like to do is cover my beds with it to keep the critters out. So I'm basically just going to wrap it all the way around here, and I put a shepherd's hook over there, and I put a little plant marker here just to kind of make it like a little temporary fence to keep out the cats and stuff. So that should work for me. It worked 2 years ago, and I'll show you video footage of that. I actually had some PVC piping I was using, and I kind of wrapped it around that in that video. Now I'll show you some old footage. I used to have a really bad problem in Florida with the birds eating my tomatoes. So I went to Walmart in the fabric section and I bought some of this little netting and I just wrapped my tomato plants up with that. And, you know, tomato plants are self-pollinating, most of them are, and so it really didn't cause a problem for me getting fruit from the tomatoes. I just wrapped them up in that little netting and kept the birds away from them. Another thing that I did in that same garden, I think it was probably the next year or maybe later that same year, was I would take little stockings, little footies, and I would wrap my tomatoes up with that. That wouldn't only just keep the birds away from them, but it would also keep away things like insects. I had a really bad problem with stink bugs in that garden, so that worked great. I got the little box of the footies, and I've already told a lot of you about that, but I got that at just a shoe store. They had you have the little boxes there. When you go in to try on shoes, I have a little box, and they gave me one when I asked for it. So, and then another thing that I like to do is trap animals. If I notice that there's a problem where things are getting really chewed down in my garden, I'll just put out a little animal trap, and I'll put the kind of food in the trap that they're eating. That was a mistake I made when I bought the trap. I got it from Harbor Freight. I would put things like carrots in there, but it was my kale that was being eaten. So I had to go back and put things like broccoli and kale in there, and then I was able to trap the possum. So we just relocate them. Whenever we trap an animal, we just take them somewhere else away from the garden. So there are 5 things for you can try out. I hope one of them works for you. Thanks so much for watching, and y'all have a beautiful day.